Hello, everyone. Welcome back to 2 Minute Tips. Let's get started. Today, we'll look at how to use filters in the Data and Analysis tab. Let's begin by clicking the Add a Filter button. Once we click this, we'll see a dropdown and some buttons appear. This is the best way to filter your data without saving the filter you are creating. If we click the Select Choice button, we'll see the different fields available to use. The fields include survey metadata, contact data, and all the questions in the survey. Unfortunately, because these are test-generated responses, we do not have any contact information. The search bar is useful when you have a long survey with a lot of questions. In this case, I only have 2 questions, but I can still use the search bar to find the exact question I want to use. I want to look at responses with a recorded date within the last 7 days. We do this by selecting the field and then selecting the operator of last 7 days. After we finish setting up the filter, the responses will filter automatically. If we wish to add another condition, we can click the plus button, which will open a prompt where we can continue creating the filter, give it a name, and save it for future use. You can also get to this prompt by clicking the downward arrow next to the Add Filter button and clicking Create a New Filter. Here, we will have the same options as before, except now we can choose for any or all of the conditions to be met, and we can insert new condition sets. I want to look at recorded responses in the last 7 days that shows either blue or green as their favorite color. To do this, I will insert a new condition set where any of the following can be true, and then select the question and acceptable answers. On the bottom left, we can see that the filtered responses have changed from 25 to 16. Before applying, let's rename this filter to GB Last 7. Then we can click Apply and Save Filter. To take the filter off, we can click this X button here. If we want to use the filter later on, we can click the downward arrow and select it, or we can apply it via the Manage Filter screen. On this screen, if we click this arrow, we can see that we can edit or duplicate the filter. We can also see the filter ID and all of the conditions that it has. Lastly, if we want to delete the filter, we can click on this trash can icon on the right. And that's it. Thank you for learning how to filter data with me today. Please remember to subscribe to the 2-minute tip category so you never miss a video. And I hope to see you around the XM community.